Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Python for Engineers short-term training program for the session 4 on our day 4. So I am always pleased to represent the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, National Institute of Technology, Nagaland. And I would like to thank the organizers of Chalapathy Group of Institutions for giving this opportunity for you and me to learn something about Python. So yesterday, we were discussing about strings and some basic concepts about strings. And we also implemented a case study from the input method. If the user is entering an integer value or a floating point value or a combination of all the characters, that is basically a string, we could identify from our program, right? Whether the entered value is an integer or a floating point or a string. Now today, we will see some more concepts about strings, exclusively on the topic of string interning. And also, we are going to understand today some non-primitive data structures in Python, that is list, tuple, and dictionary. So these are the two topics that we are going to learn today. Yesterday, I think if I am not wrong, the participant name, I think it is Swati. She asked whether string is mutable or immutable. Then I told, let us first talk about what is iterable object. For example, string is an iterable object where you can actually access individual element of a string. But in case if it is an integer, you cannot access the individual element because integer is a value as a whole, not group of characters or strings together, right? Now, let us start our today's topic with the concept of what is mutable object and what is immutable object. Okay, so let me try to open the same program or you can say understanding immutable strings. So the name itself is saying strings are immutable. Oh, sorry. I need to write NPP means open the notepad plus plus. Now, the first topic that we are trying to understand today is what is immutable? What is mutable object? And obviously, what is immutable object? And strings are immutable objects in Python. So we will try to understand these three concepts here. Basically, what is an immutable or what is an mutable object? Okay, to understand the concept of mutable object and immutable object. Okay, see, always we say, right now, if you can see the pandemic situation, right? People are saying that there is a new mutant of COVID-19. What does it mean? Because it changes its property or it has changed, it has evolved something new. So same thing, mutable means something which can change. Sorry. Immutable means something which cannot be changed.
Can you share the screen, sir?
Oh, sorry, sir. Sorry. Yeah. I forgot to share. Oh, yeah. Thank you, sir, for reminding me.
No problem.
Thank you, Sujit, sir. Yeah. Sorry, guys. I forgot to share my screen. Anyways, so today we are going to learn about what is mutable object and what is immutable object, right? Now, as I was telling you, mutable means something which can change. Immutable means something which cannot change. So to understand more about the concept of mutable and an immutable object, let me just write a simple example. My string is equal to Python. Python workshop. Okay, now when I say print my string, it will display Python workshop. There is absolutely no doubt in that, right? And there is no big concept here. We are only printing the value of my string. Now I would like to replace or immutable object means you cannot change the value of the string. You cannot change the value of a string, then only string can be immutable in Python. Immutable means which cannot change its value. Now let me type short term training program. So what I am doing here, according to the definition what I have just now mentioned, an object which cannot changes its value is only immutable. But for a naked eye here, we can clearly see that I am able to change the value of my string. I am able to change the value of my string. But in line number 3, what I said is strings are immutable. Strings are immutable. So what is an immutable object? An object whose value cannot be changed, whose values cannot be altered. So definitely there is a contradiction here in my own explanation itself. At one point I am telling you can't change the value of an object, then only it is immutable, and I am saying that strings are immutable. At the same time, in our program itself, in line number 4 and line number 6, actually we are changing the value. Let me just execute and show whether Python will agree with this program or will it throw any syntax error. So here, when you are seeing the program's output, okay, here the definition of immutable objects is contradicting with the outcome of the program. Correct? Everybody, you can see that I could change the value of my string. I could change the value of my string. So in Python, strings are immutable. Strings are immutable. That means you cannot change the value of the string once it is defined. But at line 6, we could actually change the value of the string. I believe everybody is with me. So now let us focus more into the address locations of or address location of my string to understand the concept of immutability or concept of immutable strings. I believe that you are able to see my screen. Concept of immutable strings in Python. So as of now, it looks like we are able to change the value. Then according to the definition, string should be mutable, but strings are immutable. How? Let me take the screenshot and clear all the drawings, and let us try to focus on the address location of my string here. When my string is Python workshop and when my string is short term training program, in both the occasions or both the instances, let us see the address of the string my string. Okay. See, I can just say in one line, strings are immutable, but I am trying to give you the in-depth concept. What is happening in the background when you are giving my string equal to Python workshop and my string is equal to short-term training program. So you can also say, for example, the address of string, my string, is we will try to do this, okay, so that it will be more meaningful when we are seeing the output. Okay, the string is just a second. Yeah, now you can see we have added only two things. One is to print the address location of my string in the first instance, at the same time second instance. Now let us try to execute and see to get more clarity. Okay, I forgot to give comma here. There is a small syntax mistake. Now clearly you see, I will try to highlight by using some annotations. I believe everybody can kindly notice when the string is Python workshop, when the string is Python workshop, the address is 53431816. But when the string is short-term training program, when the string is short-term training program, you can clearly see that the object's address has changed from 53431816 to 53450136. That means for you, the object name is MyString, but for Python, both are two different objects. The first one was removed at line number 7. I believe that you will get more clarity by highlighting the things. So at line 7, the earlier instance of my string object is deleted from the memory and a new instance my string object is created again with a new address location. That means at this point of time, in this program, or you can say in this program, we cannot say that we change the value of my string. Why? Because the address locations are different. The earlier instance is completely deleted and a new instance of my string is created. But what is a mutable object? Mutable object means without changing the address location, you shall be able to change the value. You shall be able to change the value. Now, let us get into some more depth to understand why strings are immutable. We need to understand one more concept here, because this concept actually is looking like a contradicting behavior earlier, but now I believe that you understood that here my string is having two different instances. MyString is having two different instances. See, when we are learning any programming language, we should always learn in depth. See, seeing the address locations will give you a very clear idea about how the objects are handled in any programming language or how a variable is handled. For example, in C language, you should work more on pointers. In Java, C++, and Python, you should try to get the address locations and try to identify the concept behind the system. Behind our understanding, behind our screen. What we are habituated in general as a engineering student is to write a program and get the output and show the output in the lab. We will get A grade, S grade, excellent grade, whatever outstanding grade it is. But when you are going for a campus selection or when you are actually working in an industry, you should show a difference between your colleague. Only then you will be able to get a good appraisal, a good increment in the package, and a good career progression. Otherwise, you may sustain for 10 years in the industry. After that, it will be very difficult for you if you do not understand the in-depth knowledge of what exactly you are doing. Okay, now let me come to the chat box and try to see in case if there is any doubt till here. Till here, if there is any doubt, please respond. Till this point of time, in case if there is any doubt. Yeah, now only I can see in the chat box, many people has responded that I didn't share my screen, but I forgot. Okay, anyways. So I believe that there is no doubt till here. To understand more, let me keep these lines in multi-line comment and because string is an iterable object. See here, string is an iterable object. What is an iterable object? Individual element in the string can be accessed separately. Is it not? Yesterday also we saw this, right? Let me again, So string is an iterable object. Why I am bringing the iterable object concept here? Let me type my string of zero. Everybody will agree with me. My string of zero will give the capital P, which is the first character. Exactly, there is no rocket science here. You can clearly see the first character has been printed. Now, can I change the, see when I am able to print, when I am able to print the first character, when we are able to print the first element in the string, it might be possible to change the first element. It might be possible or it might not be possible. Both the situations are there. It might be possible or it may not. Okay. So now let us try to understand that concept like my string of zero is equal to, let me change the P as J. Let me change the first element of the string into capital letter J. Now, ideally, if strings can be changed, if the value of string can be changed, ideally it should become Jython workshop. Instead of Python workshop, it should become Jython workshop. Okay, let me type the entire my string and also my string. My string of 0. Yeah. Now let us try to understand this concept. Okay. So there is a small mistake here. Let me now execute and show you what will be the outcome of the program. So let me just try to. Okay, so clearly you can see that in the output, initially Python workshop is displayed. Initially, Python workshop is displayed. Later, the value p is also displayed. Correct? So when you are, let me try to highlight. From this line, I could print the Python workshop, and from this line, I could also print the Python workshop and also the identity. Then from my string of 0, I could print the first character, but at line number 17, exactly at line number 17, it is saying that string object does not support item assignment. What does it mean? It means that in the earlier instance, entire my string instance is deleted and a new instance is created. That's why we were able to look that the value of my string is changed, but actually it is two different instances of my string object. But here, because strings are immutable, we could not change an element in the string. But earlier, we could change the entire value of a string. This is due to the deletion of the first instance and recreating another instance of string object, my string. But right now, we are not changing the entire string. If you are changing the entire string, what will happen? It will remove the old instance and then it will recreate a new instance. But here you are keeping all the other characters as it is. We are trying to modify only the first character or any individual element. We are trying to modify the first character by keeping rest of the characters intact. So it is not possible because strings are immutable. Strings are immutable. So I believe you guys have got a clear understanding about whether string is mutable or immutable. Now, in case if you have any doubt, please let me know in the chat box. Let me clear all the drawings. I have taken the screenshot. So I believe yesterday one of the participant who asked is also present here, and you are also on this. Elements cannot be replaceable in total. That's what I am trying to say. One of the participant is asking again, elements cannot be replaceable and total. See, total string also is not replaceable because it is not using the same address location. If it is using the same address location, then only you can say that the total string is replaceable. Okay, next doubt is, why did not it print step 18? Okay, so one of the participant is asking a question, why the output of line number 18 and 19 are not coming? Okay, let me just try to write. Why line 18 and 19 are not printed? That's the question. Answer is very, very simple. You are trying to, at line 17, we are doing something which is against what is allowed in Python. So there was an exception raised. Basically, there was an error. What is that error? The error is, see here, type error. String object does not support. So you cannot assign an, or you cannot update, you cannot actually, once a string is defined, you cannot change individual element. That's what it is, type error here. Str object does not support item assignment. So Python interpreter abruptly exited from the program's execution. I hope I clarified the doubt of the participant clearly. I believe that the doubt is clarified. Now let me again check the chat box, and in case if there are any doubts, let me take it one by one. Mr. Subhash Mekapati, did you understand why the print in step 18 and 19 did not come? Okay, is there any doubt in understanding why strings are immutable? I believe that there is no doubt. Now, let us try to understand some more concepts about strings, that is string interning. What is interning? As we already understood in detail, integer interning means saving the integers in some locations and using those locations instead of creating different instances. Correct, is it not? That means some values are cached in one part of memory, and whenever you are using those values, instead of creating multiple instances, it is actually recreating a new instance. It is only using the same instance instead of recreating the instance additionally, right? Similarly, there is a concept called as string interning. Then what is string interning? It's very clear. String interning means saving the strings in a cache memory and reusing the same address locations for others if the values are same. Okay. Then what strings are interned and what strings are not interned. Okay, Subhash Makapati is asking another question. Sir, then is it obvious that any program does not execute after an error? Subhash Makapati, I would like to tell you, unless until you handle the exceptions, unless until you handle the exceptions, I think Akash also has responded immediately. Until unless you handle the exception, always a program, when it is encountered with an error, the program execution will terminate abruptly. And another is asking, why the Python developers made string immutable? Why it is immutable? Okay, so let us try to understand some more concepts of string interning. In case if your doubt might get automatically clarified, okay, why strings are immutable? Okay, now let us try to understand the string interning concept. That let me go to the Python command prompt. Let me go to the Python command prompt and try to assign my string one is equal to Python. Now print my string one and also print the address of my string one. Address of my string one. Now I got the address of my string one. 5277-0912. Let me assign another string with name my string 2, but the value is same Python. Value is same Python. Let me print my string 2. Obviously, it will print Python. Let us try to understand what is the address of my string 2. Everybody, please observe, there are two string objects here. What I mean to say is, when you are writing my string one is equal to Python, what it has done is, it has created Python. Okay. And the address location is 5277-0912. This is the address location, and this is called as the instance my string one. When this happened, when you have written the line my string one equal to Python, all these things happened. At exactly at this point of time, it has given an address location and it has stored the string Python. Now, when I am creating another string with the same value Python, with the same value Python, now what it has done, let me try to explain here what happened. See, this is the first thing. Now, when you are writing my string 2, when you are writing my string 2 in Python, in the system level, basically, this is hidden to the end user. You cannot understand what is happening in the background unless until you just see the address locations. Okay. unless the end user, unless until the end user observes the address locations. Okay, what exactly happened was the system looked for a string with a value Python. Because it is found in the location 52770912, when mystring2 is instantiated. Instantiated means basically the object is created. When mystring2 is instantiated with the same value of mystring1 object, instead of creating a new memory location for mystring2, system has assigned the same location. This property is known as string interning. This property is known as string interning. That means string Python is cached at runtime. Because why at runtime? It is not like integer interning. See here. It is not like integer interning. Why it is not like integer interning? In integers, or in the case of, in this case, when Python application started, by default the values from -5 to 256 are cached. Whether you use it or not, they will be cached. Other values, randomly it will generate some address location. But in string interning, during the runtime, the strings are cached. During the runtime, strings are cached. In string interning, as Python will not store any strings by default, rather during runtime the caching of strings takes place. So I am trying to explain very much in detail so that you will know the concept very clear, because you are going to have a campus placement. So in case if any campus is asked, definitely people are using Python in real time projects, in the student level projects, in PhD level people are implementing their research work in Python. So most likely in this generation, I am not saying if you learn Python that is enough, but if you are very much strong in C language also, that is enough. Okay, in case if anybody is asking you in which programming language you are implementing your project, so definitely if you are very strong in Python, no campus recruiter will see whether you know all the advanced concepts in any programming language. Initial questions what they will ask is a very fundamental. Okay, so in case if you are very strong, then most likely you will be satisfying the interviewer. Now what happens here is, exactly at this point of time, even my string location will be shared with my string 2 location will be shared with my string 1. So here what is happening? Memory is saved. Memory is optimally utilized instead of creating 2 instances, only 1 instance is created. That is the first advantage of string interning. Definitely a question may arise, what will happen if you change the value of my string 2 to some other? As I already explained you, when you change the value of my string 2 to some other, obviously it will become a different string. So let me also show you that question. Now at this point of time, tell me whether the concept is clear or not. Only till here, whatever I have explained, whether you understood or not. Let me check the chats. Okay, Akash is telling me, asking me, what is the difference between integer interning and string interning? As I told you, Akash, let me again repeat. Integer interning takes place when you launch the Python application. But string interning takes place when you actually execute some instructions in the string using a program or in the Python command prompt during runtime. There is a difference. Before the runtime, integers are cached. But during the runtime only, strings are interned. Akash, did you get the... Swati is asking a question. In integer interning, are 2 variables with same value share the same location? Obviously, Swati, not only 2 variables, any number of variables, in case if they are using -5 to 256. Okay, and let me be very clear, Swati. Imagine you did not use any numbers in Python program. Still -5 to 256 are interned. I hope it is clear, Swati. Okay. In case, if you do not use, for example, let me take the program of a string, right? Even though if you do not use any integer, still -5 to 256 are interned in Python. Okay. Now, another person, Sushant, is asking me privately, where I can get previous recordings. So I think every time I am telling you, kindly do not send me private messages. It distracts the flow of the class. And at the same time, if you are in the WhatsApp group, I think the organizer, Professor Uday Kiran, is continuously sending you all the YouTube locations.
YouTube in the WhatsApp group also.
Yeah. I think still some people are sending me, sir. Sushant.
Anyhow, we will share the link here also in the chat box.
Yes, sir. Subhash Mekapati is asking, what is runtime? Okay. Mr. Subhash, runtime means when the program is under execution. Compile time means when the program is compiled but not executed. Runtime means when you are actually executing the program. Let me just clarify Mr. Subhash Mekapati's doubt. Okay. Let me come out. Okay. See, I just launched the Python command prompt. Now, imagine I am not executing anything. Even then the integers are interned. The moment you launch the Python in your machine, either from the command prompt or when you are executing the program, that also. The moment the Python is deployed in the when you are actually running the Python application, that time itself, the integers are cached. What is runtime? Let me tell you. Py. Let me go to some program. No. Add two numbers. Subhash, please listen carefully. Now, I am executing add two numbers. Now, I am not typing anything. Actually, it is expecting I will enter two numbers. This is runtime. Basically, when the program, when it is under execution, it is called as execution time or runtime. Now, if I am typing 34, again it is waiting for another input. I am not entering. This is runtime. Now, the program has successfully completed and came out. That means program has executed. That is execution time. And now program has come out. Now it is not execution time. When the program is under execution by the CPU, that time the program will become process. I think when you heard about operating system subject, I think it will be very clear. Okay, Subhash, is your doubt clear? Now roll number 185. Okay, Subhash's doubt is cleared. Now let me read the doubt asked by Divya. 18561 Divya. She is asking, can you please explain once the difference of string and integer interning? Divya, I already explained you. Let me also explain one more time. Simple string program dot py. Divya, for your clarification, I am writing one simple program. That is simple string program. In this program, everybody stay with me. Divya, please understand, in this program, am I using any integer? Divya, kindly respond in the chat. So I am mentioning the names. I am not trying to offend you. Mimmalni ibbandi padatledu. I am just trying to get more interaction and more lively so that you guys will be in, you guys will feel that it is like a normal class, not a online class. Okay. Now, Divya, in this program, we are not using any integer, but Python caches -5 to 256 when Python is launched. Python is launched means when you are executing Python. Okay. During the program execution, the strings are cached. Not all the strings. That we are going to tell. Not all the strings, but few are cached. Because all the numbers are not cached. No, because you cannot just like that cache everything. I told you yesterday an example. Just because you have a refrigerator, you cannot keep all the fruits available in the market in the fridge, which also will have a capacity. So like that, your primary memory has a capacity, and your primary memory is not only for Python. It is for all the applications. For example, you have a mobile. In your mobile, can you keep on install all the play? You can keep on install all the mobile apps? No, you cannot keep because your memory is limited. And at the same time, you cannot run all the apps also because your RAM is limited. I believe everybody understood. Divya, whether you use any number or not, Python, when it is launched, it caches -5 to 256. Why it caches? In case in your program, if any values are used, it will share those locations. But in string interning, only when you execute, it will be cached. Did you understand the difference, Divya? So this is the difference between integer and string interning. Okay. Now let me go to the chat box. Only explain integer. One more. It's okay, Subhash. You cannot be need not be from CSC background. One more student is asking. Only explain integer. Yesterday and day before yesterday, Lalita Parmeshwari, I have explained integer interning. Kindly, in case if you have missed those sessions, please see the recordings. Okay. Next doubt is, Srikant is asking, as the strings are immutable, in case if you want to change the given string, then what we have to do? Srikant, I already told you, you can change the entire value. You can change the entire value, Srikant. You can change the entire value, Srikant. I already told you. My string equal to Python workshop, my string equal to short term training program. Then what it has done for you, whether it is a two different instances or not, it does not matter. No, Srikant, you can still change the entire value so that it will create a new instance and still you can use those values. I hope I have explained Srikant's doubt also. Now let us go forward. Okay. Let us go forward and try to understand how many strings are interned. Everybody, let me give a couple of minutes break here, because I am also continuously speaking and you are listening to me. I think we will take 2 minutes break and we will resume the session immediately. Okay, participants, I think now we will continue our session. I believe I am very much audible to you and you are still able to see my screen. Now a simple Python string, the string which has a value Python is interned, correct? So now let us try to understand some more concepts of understand string interning dot py. Let us try to understand some more concepts about string interning. Okay, so for that, let me just write my string is equal to Python. Then print the string is my string and the address is ID of my string. Address is ID of my string. Okay. Now, as we already, I can also change this as, sorry, I can change this as my string one, and then my string two. Initially, let us take the same value. Let us take the same value. Okay. You can say the string one is, and here string two is. Obviously, it will get the same address locations. py I have done some mistake here. My string is, oh, okay. My string one, sorry. My string one. And here also my string one, and the last print is my string two and my string two. I'm not trying to explain the same thing again, but I am trying to explain you what strings are cached, what strings are not cached. To understand that, let me take the previous example. Here clearly you can see that Python is cached. Python is cached because both are same. Looks like my string one and my string two are cached, correct? Because of same address locations. Now let me change my string to Python space. Everybody please observe, now there is a space after Python. My string one is only Python, my string two is Python space. We added a space after Python. I hope everybody is noticing that. Now let me execute. Everybody please observe clearly, when there is an additional space, for a human being both are same, Python and Python with space, but for the system they are not same. When we added a space in my string two, we can notice that the address locations are different. That means what? Both are not sharing the same location because the strings are different. Because the strings are different. Because the strings are different, they are not sharing the location in this case. Now, let me try to add one more thing now in the program to understand clearly what exactly is interned, what is not interned. Okay, I believe you guys are with me. Now, let me take another string called as my string 3, which is equal to, let me take my string 3, which is equal to my string 1, and change everywhere into my string 3. See, purposefully, what I am doing here is I am taking my string 1 as my string 3 and my string 2 as my string 4. I believe everybody understood 1 and 3 are same, 2 and 4 are same. Now let us see what exactly happens. So here, let me also change the value as my string 4 and ID of my string 4. So let me execute the program and show you clearly that String 1 and string 3 are sharing the same location. String 2 and string 4 are sharing the same location. You can clearly notice here. String 1 and string 3 are sharing the same location. And at the same time, I am unable to draw properly, but still, yeah, now you can see clearly that string 2 and what does it mean? All compile time constants. See here, all strings which are compile time constants are interned in Python. What is compile time constant? Simply, I am assigning my string 1 equal to Python, my string 2 equal to Python space. So that is basically a compile time constant. Because in the program's execution, I am not changing anything. Like I am not asking another prompt from the user and changing the things, nothing. This kind of assignment is called as compile time constant. For example, I equal to 10, I is a compile time constant. String equal to ABC, string is a compile time constant. The assignment, directly while giving some value, they are called as compile time constants. They are interned in Python. That's why strings 1 and 3 are sharing the same location, and also strings 2 and 4 are sharing the address location, sharing the same address here. That means the compile time constant strings are interned in Python. Now let me give more clarity. What is non-compile time constant? When I am talking about compile time constant, that means there should be some string which is formed during runtime also. I believe all the participants will understand what is compile time and runtime. See, compile time means which is not defined during execution time. I believe that participants who are there here, let me tell you an example in C language. In C language, array size is assigned during compile time. That is called a static memory allocation. But when you use malloc, calloc, realloc and free, and when you use pointers concept, that is memory creation during runtime. I believe now you are able to understand what is compile time and what is runtime. Okay, compile time constants are cached in Python. Now, whether all the compile time constants are interned, the answer is no. Next question is whether all the compile time constants are interned in Python. No. The answer is no. That means some are not interned. Then why they are not interned and what is the use? Let us try to understand now. Let me clear the drawings. I have taken the screenshot of it. I believe you might have understood this segment of program. Now, let me again take my string one again and let me write Python . So I have written Python many times. If you really want to know, you can also type the length of the string. You will come to know. Okay. You can say print the length of string one is len of len. I think you guys know. My string one. I'm just trying to show you the output and then we will see some other concepts like what is exactly interned and what is not. py understand string interning dot py. Here there is no. Now the length of the string one is 54 characters. The length of the string one is 54 characters. Okay. I simply copied Python multiple times. Now let us try to define the same thing with my string two also. Means I am increasing the length of the string here with a purpose. I increased the length of the string and trying to reuse it again. So that we will see whether this is cached or not. Let me also type everywhere. I think, okay, here also I need to change string two. Now let me execute this program once again. So when it is a compile time constant, even if a big string is interned, even is a big string is interned, what does it mean? Irrespective of the length of the string, when a string is compile time constant, it is interned. Now some people may get a doubt, hey, why this guy has simply put python and just showing the same thing, like first one is simple Python, it is cached, now it is a 54 character that is also stored. What is the advantage of this string interning? I'm going to execute one program and show you the real benefit of string interning. Just wait for another 15 minutes. Okay. Now, let me keep this as it is. Now, let me take one more example. Okay. Again, I will take the same string one. I sincerely believe that the sessions are useful, including today's session. Okay. And let me just tell you, I will put Python underscore workshop. What I put? Python underscore workshop. It is definitely less than 54 characters, correct? It is less than 54 characters. Okay. Now, let me take it the same thing as string 2 also. Let me take it as string 2. Like, write the same Python workshop. Okay. Obviously, everybody now will tell me that, sir, definitely this also will be interned. When Python, 54 character string is interned, both are Python workshop. Okay. And there is no gap, etc. Exactly the same string, you see. No extra space, nothing. See, you can see that both are matched. Green color is coming in the text editor. Obviously, both will share the same location. There is no big deal in this. If I execute, both are interned. Now, let me add one exclamatory mark. Everybody, please observe. Let me also keep this as it is. And see, I am keep on adding new lines so that at the end of the day, when I am sharing the program, you can execute different segments of the program and understand the difference as well. I am putting exclamatory mark. It's for a human being, it's not a big deal, no? Python underscore workshop and one exclamatory mark is there. When compared to the previous execution and this execution, let me execute and show you the difference. Obviously, this is also interned. Okay. Now, let us use another method. Okay. Available in Python. Okay. That is mystring1 equal to, everybody please see Python. Now, mystring2 is equal to, I am taking an empty string. Everybody please see here. I am taking an empty string, then dot join. This is also another way to join elements in a string. A string has a method called as join. Sorry guys, I just had a small interruption. Okay, so mystring1 is Python. It's a string. Basically, you can use double quotes also here because single quote or double quote is just a string. Now, I am trying to form mystring2 instead of directly giving Python. I want to give an empty string dot join Okay, join. Everybody, please see here. I am giving a list of characters. P, Y, T, H, O, and finally N. For an empty string, this is not compile time. Why it is not compile time? Because you are calling a method join only during the runtime only that method will be called. Okay, so my string 2 is a runtime formed string, or you can say my string 2 will be formed only during the execution time, but whereas my string 1 is a compile time constant. Now let me first print my string 1 and print my string 2. My string 1 and my string 2. So here let me try to execute the program. Now both the strings are exactly looking one and looking same, or you can say that both the strings are similar only. From the print statement, both are Python. Both are Python only. What you have to understand is string 1 is a compile time string. String 2 is formed during execution time. Okay. Now, to understand clearly what we need to do, let us check the address locations of both the strings. Okay, now for that, I can directly say, I think there is a statement, no? Yeah, let me copy this. I can keep this in comment and let me print the string 2 also. One second, guys. I went somewhere. Yeah. Now, let us try to understand what are the address locations. So let me execute the program. So okay, there are some queries like Swati is telling me in Java we compile with Java C and we execute the Java program. What about Python? We are executing directly. Swati, the py, when you are using Python, pythonprogram.py or py, it actually does both. It will compile and execute together. But if you want to see, you can go back and see in the details of how Python is an interpreter. To be very honest, Python is an interpreter. And Subhash is asking me, I did not understand compile time constants. Subhash, I'm going to give you one link in the chat box also, and also in the WhatsApp group, because you are from a
Nagaraj sir, your mic option is not there, sir.
Kiran sir, man, look, sir, connect you are disconnected.
Okay.
Okay, 1 minute. Connect right to man, definitely. What charge?
Which one? Can you mic call it?
That problem of disconnect.
Mic option is there.
సార్ ఏమైనా ఇష్యూ ఉందా?
లేరు.
ఓకే సార్. ఓకే ఓకే మొబైల్ హాట్స్పాట్ మారుస్తున్నారు అట్లా ఫర్ 2 మినిట్స్.
ఓకే
ఇట్స్ బెటర్ టు పాజ్ ద రికార్డింగ్ అమౌంట్ ఇన్ ద మీన్ టైమ్.
ఎస్ సార్ ఎస్ సార్
Yeah, sorry, participants.
Nagaraj sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Got it. Share your screen, sir.
Yes, 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 yes. Sorry, guys. Due to some internet issue, I changed the mobile hotspot, and I believe that in another 40 minutes it will not cause any issue.
Okay, sir. Done. Your screen is shared.
Yeah, yeah. So I was talking about something called as a Python, which is created. During runtime, that is mystring 2, and mystring 1 is a compile time constant. Okay, why it is compile time constant, I will tell you. See, very simple. Try to compile this program. Compile means it will search for syntax errors and it will allocate some memory for static things. For example, mystring 1 Python, during compilation itself it will know. But second thing, the second line, that line number 32, only when you execute the dot join method will be called. That's why mystring 2 will be formed only during the program execution, but mystring 1 is formed during the compilation process itself. Subhash Naikapati, I hope you can get one idea. And Swati, now I cannot see the chat earlier replies. I think Swati is asking the difference between Java, Java C, right? Java C and Java. But in Python, when you call py and the program name with extension, it actually executes the program, and Python is an interpreter. Okay, now if you want to understand about the Python's executable file and all, I think this is not the platform to discuss that scenario. So let me continue and show you the program's output now. Earlier, what was the output? Python, Python. So both look same. Now let us try to execute the program and see the address locations. Now, please see the output. Both are Python only, but the addresses are different. Now, in case if you have observe the addresses are not same, but the values are 5 and 5. Is it not? Python does not intern strings formed during runtime. Okay, to get more understanding, if you want to know again, you just keep hash here and simply write mystring2 is equal to, copy this. I already showed you. Okay, then take mystring3 here. Take mystring3 now. Oh, sorry. Copy here, type mystring3. Okay, basically all the strings are having the same value, that is Python only, but string1 and string2 are compile time constants, whereas string3 is formed during runtime. So in Python, runtime formed strings are not cached. Runtime formed strings are not cached. See here, string2, string3, string1 and string2 are compile time constants. So cached, but string3, even though, or you can say, even though the string3 is having the same value like string1 and string2. Strings 1 and 2, it is not cached. Runtime, because system cannot understand what is the formation of string3 unless until it get executed. When it gets executed, it will not be cached. There are so many concepts in string interning. Okay, it may not be possible to see what is interned, what is not interned. So for the benefit of the participants, I am sharing one location from the internet. Okay, I will keep the link in the WhatsApp group also later on. Now let me just pose the string. Now, let us not break our heads on what strings are interned, what strings are not interned, but rather let us continue and see in this half an hour session, what is the advantage of string interning? I have given one link. Okay. You can go through this link and it will clearly explain what is interned, what is not interned. Okay. There is beautiful explanation is given. If you can go through all the things, clearly it is giving everything. Exactly which string will be interned and which string is not interned. Okay. So, let me explain you one more thing, that one benefit is memory is saved. How memory is saved? Why? Because instances are sharing. Let me tell you another benefit. Okay. Let us understand now for another 20 minutes or so, what is the benefit of string interning other than saving memory space? What is the benefit of string interning other than saving memory space. Okay, then what will happen? Let us try to understand. The CPU execution is enormously saved. Basically, the CPU execution time is enormously saved during string comparison. Some people may not exactly realize what is CPU execution time. How come CPU execution time is saved during string comparison, right? Let me explain you one small logic here. What is string comparison? I think everybody will know. Comparing strings. What is string comparison? What is string comparison? I think in C language, C++, Java, people will know, right? What is string comparison? Comparing each character in two strings, and when each character is matched, we can say both the strings are same. For example, let me write string 1 is equal to Python, string 2 is equal to Python. So here, when you are comparing whether you are, for example, in C language, there is a string library method named strcmp, s1 comma s2. I believe people can recollect what I am saying. In C language, there is a, now what this method will do, strcmp returns 0 when both the strings are same. What is same? When each and every character is same. strcmp returns positive value when string 1 is bigger than string 2. I believe what is bigger and what is smaller, no? I hope you guys will understand. In case if the ASCII value of a character is bigger than, okay, I'm not trying to explain you the C language concepts or the string comparison concepts here, but here, when string 2 is bigger than string 1. Now, without using strcmp, we can also write our own logic of comparing character by character. Correct? Comparing character by character using loops in C language. Correct? Now, whether you are using, see here, in both the cases means whether you use, that means using strcmp or without using strcmp, the string, or you can say the character in the string, in the strings, are compared one by one. So it takes some CPU time to compare the character by character. I believe everybody is able to understand what I am saying. What I am saying is, when you are comparing strings, CPU will take some time. It may be very less time. For a human being, the CPU execution time will be very, very less, but it takes some time, some CPU clock cycles. For example, if you are an ECE student, you can say that some CPU clock cycles, the microprocessor will take some CPU clock cycles. For example, if you are a CSC, ECE, EEE student, you might have studied microprocessor, you might have studied computer organization, or you might have studied operating system. In everywhere, in every subject which I mentioned just now, you will know these concepts. What is CPU time? What is CPU clock cycle? The amount of time CPU is taking to execute is basically CPU time or a CPU clock cycle. Okay. Now let us come to the Python. Let us check the advantage in string interning using or while comparing strings. That's what our task, no? Comparing each character with interning, without interning. What is the advantage? As I told you earlier, here, CPU execution time enormously is saved. No, I am trying to justify this particular statement. I am trying to justify this statement here. The CPU execution time is enormously saved during string comparison when you intern the string. Okay, so let us now use a program and try to understand, is it really true? Is it really true? Okay, now to understand, let me show you mystring1 is equal to Python. Then mystring2 also I will write the same, is equal to Python. Now in Python, to verify whether the strings are same or not, you can type something like this: mystring1 double equal to mystring2. What is double equal to here? Let me tell you, double equal to operator compares string character by character and returns true when all the characters are matched in both the strings with the same index. So string 1 of 0 is equal to string 2 of 0. String 1 of 1 is equal to string. I hope everybody understood. Okay, now what is the length of Python? Python. It's a 6 character string. Python is a 6 character string. Let us not write all those things. So checking character by character needs some time. But within a split of a second, it has given me true. Why? Because CPU is very fast in execution, right? Now, I can also check. Everybody, please observe. I am changing the statement and now I am writing mystring1 is mystring2. What is easier? Is an also an operator. Both are giving true. double equal to is giving true, is also giving true. Okay, now what is? Let me check the chat box. Okay, there is no doubt, only attendance links are posted. So let me come back and try to make you understand is operator compares the address locations of the strings of both the strings and returns true when both the strings share the same address locations. Basically, what we need to understand here, is double equal to checks 6 characters in total, correct? But is checks only the location. Now you guys tell me, in case, imagine the string is of length 54, double equal to checks 54 characters, correct? One by one. But is verifies only one, or you can say is operator need only one comparison. That is, check the addresses. In case if there is an, suppose now CPU execution time will be saved when the strings are interned. Basically, if the string is interned, what will happen? CPU execution will drastically reduce in case if you use is operator. Okay, now sometimes there might be confusion. Hey, how come this guy is telling theoretically that CPU time will be reduced? So let us check a program to prove that CPU execution with double equal to takes more time than CPU execution with is operator. Unless until we write a program and see, you should not believe anybody, right? You should not believe me, right? So now let us see a small program. And try to understand, is it really true? And theoretically, it is very, very simple to understand now. Checking character by character, suppose if the string is a 30,000 length string. Sir, how come a 30,000 string length is interned? Imagine it is a compile time constant or a repetition operator. Let me show you. Okay. Let me show you one small piece of code where we can really see impact of CPU execution time. Okay. So before the program is shown to you, let me just tell string 1 is equal to, everybody please see here, Python, there is a repetition operator, right? 3000. That means Python is repeated 3000 times. Now tell me, what is the length of the, I will not type the string 1 because it will be huge. Let me type the length of string 1. It's an 18,000 character string. How come it is 18,000? Why? Because Python is a 6 character and 3000 times it is repeated. Even this is interned in Python. Imagine you are having such kind of string. And let me tell you, the same thing, Python into 3000. Now let me type the length of string 2. Oh, I have given a small mistake. So let me do one thing. For the sake of taking a clear screenshot, let me again just start. String 1. Length of string 1. Then let me take string 2 and length of string 2. Now, if you say string 1 double equal to string 2, what it will do? Compares character by character. That means 18,000 characters are verified. But it has given me immediately true. Why? Because the CPU is so fast in execution. Even when I am typing is, now it has given me false. How come? Why? Because string 1 and string 2 are, I think repetition is not interned. No. Yes. It is not interned. It is not interned in case of repetition of this much length. Now, how much time it will take, to check both are same or both are not same. Okay. Let us try to execute one small program and I will show you the amount of CPU time required for double equal to and is operator. Okay. So let me open a program here. I am trying to tell you from when you are executing a single command, the output will come very fast. Okay, but now let us try to execute a program here. See here, I am calling, if you guys don't understand what is DEF, tomorrow I am going to explain. DEF is nothing but a function. DEF is nothing but a function. In this class, you try to just understand, there is a function called as compare with equality. Then another program called as, another function called as compare identity. See, there are two functions. One, in one function, you can see clearly, I am using double equal to. Another function, I am using ISEs. Now, let me explain you the logic inside this particular program. Imagine, I want to know the amount of time that is executed by the CPU. So what I need to do? See here, I want to calculate the time. So what I will do is, there is a package called as time. time.time has given me the number of clock ticks in my machine. It is giving me the number of clock ticks. You may not exactly understand, there is a big value here. Number of seconds elapsed in my laptop. If you type time.time, it will give us different value. Okay. Now, again, I am typing. Everybody, please observe. After, there is a time gap between the first time.time and the second time.time. Clearly, you can mention there is a difference in the number of clock ticks. There is a difference in the number of clock ticks. Okay. So let us try to understand why I am explaining this time.time is because in the program it is being used. Okay. Now, if I execute time.time again, there is a time difference. Correct? There is a time difference. So what I would like to do is, let me come and execute again time.time. Let me execute again time.time. Now you can see there is more difference now in the clock ticks. There is more difference in the clock ticks. So by making use of this logic, what exactly I am trying to do in the program, let me show you. Let me clear the annotations first. Clear the drawings. And so for that, I am taking import time. Why I am using time here? Because I want to execute a function with equal to operator. So I want to take the starting time, and after the function is over, again I want to take the time. So two times I will take and see the difference of seconds. Okay, for that, everybody please try to understand the function. Do not worry about DEF. Do not worry about DEF. I will tell clearly tomorrow. Okay, DEF means a function definition. DEF is a shortcut of definition. Now, please try to understand the program which I am trying to highlight here. Okay, let me explain line by line. Now, what is this? A function where a variable is passed, that is n. What is n? I will tell you now. What is n? I will tell you. Okay, now, what is string 1? Python underscore programming into 5000. What is string 2? Python underscore programming into 5000. That means it's a huge string. It's a huge string. Now, I want to compare whether both the strings are same or not. For that, what I am doing, everybody please observe. I am calling a loop. What I am doing is n number of times I am comparing to show you there is a real difference in the execution time. I am not calling string 1 equal to string 2 once. I am calling n number of times. What is n? See here, I am passing n here. 10 to the power of 7 here. 10 to the power of 7 is really more. Okay, so let me decrease the argument 10 to the power of 7 here in line number 27, 8 when I am executing. So 10 to the power of 7 number of times, string 1 and string 2 are equality is compared. If both are equal, simply do nothing. What is pass? Pass is like continue. Pass is like continue, or pass means nothing. Pass means nothing in Python. Don't do anything. Again, run the loop second time, third time, fourth time, fifth time, like 10 power 7 here. Okay. Let me clear all the drawings and let me just come down and show you. Do not worry about line number 21 to 26. Okay, I will explain you. See here, I am taking, suppose time dot time. I am taking the current time as start time. Then in line number 28, I am calling the function compare with equality operator. Let me call 10,000 times only. See, because 10,000 power takes more number of time and we need to wait for more time. Let me call 10,000 times. Okay. Now, what I am doing before calling the function that is equality operator, that is double equal to 10,000 times, I am taking the time. And after calling the function, again, I am taking the time. And then I am taking the subtraction. Basically, I am taking the time difference. Basically, time dot time will give you the number of seconds in my laptop. So when you are subtracting, it will give the sum of difference of how much seconds it has taken. How much seconds it has taken. Similarly, I am defining another function. The function is exactly same like the above. Only thing is, above function will have double equal to, here it has is. Again, I am calling, see here, first I am calling compare with equality. I want to show you in a single screen. Everybody, let me just show you. First, I am calling with equality 10,000 times. Then next time I am calling is operator function also 10,000 times. Before calling the function, I am reading the time. After calling the, once the function is over, again I am taking the time and taking the time difference and trying to print the time difference to show you how much time it will take with double equal to, how much time it will take with is. Okay, only thing which you should not worry now is what is DEF? DEF is a function definition which I will explain you tomorrow. Okay, now let me execute the program. Py string interning dot py. 10,000 times when you are calling string equality operator, you see with equality it has taken 1.07 second, but with is, sorry, with e, yeah, with identity. With identity, see, equality means double equal to. With identity, it has taken 0.008 seconds only. If you really check the logic, purposefully we are calling multiple times. Purposefully we are calling multiple times to show you the time difference. Now, you increase this to 1 lakh. Actually, you increase this to 10 power 7 or 10 power 8. I have actually executed and saw if I call 10 power 7 times, equality will take 8 minutes, but is operator will take very, very less minutes. I don't have time now to show you with 10 power 7 because we are running out of time. So you guys can execute the program in your machine. Now I change it to 1 lakh. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's 1 lakh. When it is 1 lakh, equality takes 5.97 seconds, but identity has taken 0.02 only. That means it is clearly proved that in case, if you want to compare a string, if the strings are not interned, there is no point of comparing with is here. See, I am not telling you every time you need to use is, okay? Only in case of a string which is interned, is will give, is will take less CPU time when compared to double equal to. So today, because of the flow of the string immutable objects and all, I think today I could not start list, dictionary, and tuple. Don't worry, tomorrow I will continue the topic. We always have a buffer time, okay? In case if any session, actually today's session shall be, by this time I should complete list, tuple, dictionary also. So don't worry, I will complete it tomorrow. List, tuple, dictionary, and functions also. Functions need not take 2 hours of time. So don't worry, tomorrow I will be on schedule, right? So now I believe Subhash is asking, how is passed here and not in the previous example Python into 3000? Subhash, try to understand. Here I am trying to calculate the CPU clock cycles with the double equal to and is. Here pass is not, pass means simply continue. Just go to the next iteration. Go to the next iteration. And some people are asking me, the link, I think, over to the